Hello everyone, welcome back or welcome to my YouTube channel. So for today's video, why is my hand like this? So for today's video is a highly requested video from Filipino workers here in Hungary. So I receive a lot of messages and comments on my YouTube channel from my previous video that I was mentioning about the conversion of Philippine driving license into Hungarian driving license, but that was last 2021, so it is not the requirements right now. There's a lot of updates, more requirements, you know. So in this video I'm going to mention the requirements for 2023 converting your Philippine driving license into Hungarian driving license. So first you need the residence permit. So let's be fast because I'm going somewhere, so I just want to do this video so it's easier, you know, it's easier than replying one by one. So first that you need is your residence permit here in Hungary, which is residence permit, work permit, and then second you need the address card. They call it lakcimkartya here, the white paper, you know, it's long white paper. This is the address card here in Hungary. And then third is you need the Philippine driving license, at least 1 year validity. And then you need also the medical certificate that you are fit to drive, and you're going to get it here in Hungary. I think before it was 7,000 plus Hungarian forint. I'm not sure, I think it increased a little bit because, you know, everything is sky high right now. I mean, yeah, I think maybe it's maybe 10,000 now, I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure it's not that, it's not more than that. And then you need passport. And then you need the international driving license. It's issued according to the 1949 Geneva Convention. I'm going to put the link in my description. So you need the international driving license according to the Geneva 1949 Geneva Convention. The Automobile Association of the Philippines, the website, they say there that the Vienna Convention format is for Europe, which is wrong because it is not following the requirement here in Hungary. So therefore you only need the Geneva Convention format. So you have to tell that you need the Geneva Convention format, not the Vienna. So and then after that you need also the certificate from the LTO stating the exact date when each category was received. So this certificate has to be apostilled and officially translated by the Hungarian embassy. So for example, your driving license, you get category B. So you have to, in the LTO certificate, it has to show the exact date. For example, you got your category B last July 9, 2012, and then you added another category. For example, you get category A, which you received just like last year. So it has to show the exact date when you received your category. So this is what they are requiring now. This is the additional, the two, they had these two additional for converting here in Hungary. Before it was easy, it was fast. It also just took me 7 days, and then they delivered it to my home. Right now, I'm not sure how long would it take. And yeah, there are more requirements, because right now I also have another category added because last year I went to the Philippines. I added category A. Category A1 is for motorbike, big bike or something. So also I didn't know that they have an additional requirement, so which I also need right now this to comply these requirements. So yeah, and I also know this one because we are hiring the truck drivers here in Hungary, and this is also their requirements. So we just find out that this is the new additional requirements this year, 2023. So yeah, I hope that this video answered all your questions, you know. Please don't forget to subscribe on my channel, and if you have any question, just please don't hesitate to comment here, and I will answer your question as soon as I can. Thank you everyone, thank you for watching, bye.